What up, peeps? This video is going to be a video about our Megadeth collection.
Yes.
We did a Metallica ranked, which we showed off all the Metallica records we have. So I guess this time we're going to do all the Megadeth ones, but we actually didn't have time to rank them, so we're just going to show you guys all that we have.
Yes.
You want to start?
Sure.
So this is all of the records in our Megadeth collection.
Yeah, so first up is Countdown to Extinction, a classic Megadeth record.
And I think we both like Megadeth more than Metallica.
Yeah, definitely. This one is a gatefold, so I'll go ahead and show you that.
Megadeth is the band that got me into metal. Probably my favorite metal band.
Mm-hmm. This record's got a lot of the classic Megadeth songs on it.
Mm-hmm.
Closure of a Dream, Sweating Bullets, Symphony of Destruction, all songs like that.
Yeah. I don't really count Type O as a metal band, so I think Megadeth is probably my favorite metal band.
Yeah. That's cool.
Alright, and then we have the picture disc version of that,
which
actually sounds pretty good for a picture disc. If you can't get that one, because it's pretty rare. This isn't bad.
Yep. Then we have Killing Is My Business. This is not the recent reissue.
I'm not really into that recent reissue.
Yeah.
This one is on red though.
Oh yeah, let me show that. This is like one of the best metal debuts.
Definitely.
And I love this color red.
Yeah, that one was limited to 2000 or less.
That label on the other side is really cool.
Mm-hmm. I'm not into the recent reissue because I don't like it when bands reissue their old stuff but add new stuff to it.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, that one's got to be in my top three Megadeth records.
That's pretty great.
Mm-hmm. Especially after getting kicked out of Metallica and putting that out.
I know. I could not imagine.
It's crazy, dude. I'd have been shitting my pants if I were ours.
So that's that.
And then we have So Far, So Good, So What.
Mm-hmm.
All of their albums are beautiful. Pretty classic. I think my favorite on here is Mary Jane or Hookin' Mouth.
Those are good ones.
Pictures. Is yours In My Darkest Hour?
Yeah.
Mostly they had more songs from this to a set.
Yeah.
But yeah. So Far, So Good, So What.
Okay. And you just picked this one up, right?
No.
You didn't? No. Or was this recent one or no?
No.
Okay. Well, this is the Music on Vinyl pressing of The System Has Failed.
Yes.
You guys know that we're big Music on Vinyl fans. So.
That one, that's such a good Megadeth record.
Yeah. I'm trying to get towards that shiny.
I think in Dave's book he said that this was supposed to be his solo album.
Mm-hmm.
But the record label, he was obligated to put up another Megadeth record.
This has got a lot of like deep cuts on it.
Yeah.
Like songs that, like if you're just like a casual fan of Megadeth, you might not be very familiar with this album.
Yeah. Songs like Die Dead Enough and Kick the Chair,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, something that I'm
Tears
not,
in a Vial.
Tears in a Vial. That, God, that's the best.
Yeah.
Alright, and then I just got this one today. This is the rare and only pressing of The World Needs a Hero. The original cover is here in the gatefold. Where Vic's coming out of Dave's stomach. I guess they censored it and just put Vic in there. But I'm glad that they included it in the gatefold.
Yeah, that's kind of cool.
This one is the album that has Dread and the Fugitive Mind on it, which is one of our favorite Megadeth songs ever.
Definitely.
This one is the one after Risk. Came out in, I think, 2001. Yeah, 2001. And this is the only vinyl pressing of it.
That's crazy.
Yeah, this is a really good one. It's got like a Hangar 18 Part 2 and stuff. What I thought was weird is I was looking at this, and then that barcode, it's got like a compact disc logo on it.
Hmm.
See that?
Yeah.
It's got like the logo for the CD on it. So I don't know if this was just taken from CD and put on vinyl by this company in England, but I'm glad that I have this.
Yeah.
This is a really good one.
Definitely.
Yep.
Alright, so this next one is your favorite.
Yep.
And my, like, second favorite.
Yeah.
Euthanasia.
Yeah, that's another, definitely my favorite.
Another classic Megadeth record. When you think of Megadeth, this is, like, the record.
For
if
us.
Not, yeah, I was gonna say, like, for us, but, like, a lot of people think, like, themselves and rest in peace and stuff like that. But for us, this is it.
Yeah, we like the 90s Megadeth more than 80s and 2000s.
Yeah. Kind of see it on the back. Vic on the baby.
Just like the guitar tones on that. I think because they tune half step down, it sounds heavier.
Yeah.
And Dave's voice on here is like better than any other Megadeth record, I think.
It sounds great. I mean, Train of Consequences is probably like the most well-known song off this record, I think.
Yeah, well, maybe it's Tu Le Monde.
Yeah, that's true. Tu Le Monde used to be my favorite Megadeth song of all time.
Yeah. I think my favorite is Addicted to Chaos.
I think mine's going to be Elysian Fields.
Yeah, that's a great one.
So, yeah. Euthanasia.
We need to get the regular gatefold version of that. But it's like 150.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, and then this is a Record Store Day release. It's the single for The Threat Is Real off of their last album, Dystopia. And this is on white vinyl. Cool. And it has a cover. It's called Foreign Policy, and I think it's by the band Fear, the punk band Fear.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, when this song came out, it was like they're back, because before this they had Super Collider out, which is like their worst album. And then this is like a really good comeback from that.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah.
I think 13 is probably the worst. That's just my opinion. And speaking of recent, this is the most recent full-length record. This is Dystopia.
Yep.
That's a pretty good record, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
I like the title track, and obviously The Threat Is Real.
Yeah, Dystopia is my favorite song.
Yeah.
And Lying in State is heavy. You know, this is a good one.
I didn't even realize that single has the first song.
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of cool. Yeah.
Nice. Alright, and then we have my second favorite Megadeth record, which you got me for Christmas, and that is United Abominations. This is a gatefold. Very beautiful artwork. Look at that.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
That is awesome. See here and stare at it all day.
Yeah. Very colorful.
There's the band up there, I never even noticed them. Yeah, it reminds me of like a Iron Maiden record. Just sit here and stare at it all day. I don't like the redone Tattoo at Le Monde in here.
I don't either.
And this was released on Roadrunner. Pretty cool label. This is my second favorite Megadeth album of all time.
Nice.
I love the title track and Washington Is Next and Sleepwalker.
For sure.
Fantastic album. This and The World Needs a Hero, I don't feel like you see too often in Megadeth collection videos on YouTube.
Yeah.
We have some of the ones that a lot of people don't really show.
Yeah, those don't get recognized enough.
Yeah.
Alright, so this one's already been mentioned, but Super Collider. A more recent one, not the most recent, but more recent. Also one of the ones that doesn't get a lot of recognition, but it's not their best, you know. But I do kind of like, I like Kingmaker. I think that's probably my
that
favorite.
Yeah.
My
favorite on there is Forgot to Remember. That's actually a really good song.
Yeah.
And the gatefold for that one is kind of cool too.
So this one, like, it's not their best, but it's definitely worth listening to if you're like just getting into Megadeth or...
Yeah.
So, if you know, as a worst Megadeth album. It's not like the worst album ever. It's just not as good as the others, but it's definitely still worth listening to.
I like 13 more than that one.
Yeah. All right.
Then Risk isn't even. I wouldn't even count that as a bad album.
No.
I like Risk a lot.
Yeah, me too.
All right, and then we have Endgame, which I got on Amazon for a normal price a while ago, and I guess now it's expensive. But yeah, this was their 2009 album. Really good. I mean, all these albums are really good. It was a really cool vehicle.
It was pretty neat.
Yeah. Got the barcode for his mohawk. This one has songs like Head Crusher and This Day We Fight, 44 Minutes. All these songs are really good. You can't really go wrong with any Megadeth albums.
Yeah.
Yeah, here's Endgame.
Cool. Alright, and this album, pretty much everybody thinks of when they think of Megadeth.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of like the three, one of the two or three that people are like, you know, people rank their best Megadeth album. This is most likely going to be it. This is Rust in Peace. Probably the most well-known song, Hangar 18. It's probably their most well-known song, I would say.
Not Holy Wars?
Either one, but they're both on here. So
yeah.
They're both their two most popular songs are on this record. A very great record.
But I think the deep tracks on that one are the best, like Take No Prisoners.
Yeah. Is this also? No, this is not Faithful. I thought it was.
That is like the most musical, technically, like gifted album of all time.
It's definitely like, if you're a person who's like oriented to guitar and like guitar playing, like this is a record for you.
Yeah, this is like the guitar bible.
Yeah.
I mean, any song that you would learn to play guitar on here is like a perfect warm-up song because they're so crazy.
Yeah.
And I've been playing for a while, and I can't get some of these songs. They're just too hard.
They are.
I mean, there's not much to say about it. I mean, this is a perfect album. Well, it's a 90s one, too.
Oh, yeah.
Alright, and then we have, of course, Peace Sells, which they've been adding songs to their set list from recently.
Which is amazing.
Yes. I love that they added The Conjuring, and I love that they added My Last Words, because My Last Words is my favorite. Probably in my top three favorite Megadeth songs. This is just a classic masterpiece.
When I first got into Megadeth, this was the album that I just played on repeat.
Yeah.
Because it's like my second favorite.
Mm-hmm. Like I said, My Last Words and The Conjuring and Good Morning Black Friday. It's probably the most evil Megadeth album because it's got like with The Conjuring, it's got like instructions on how to like put a hex on people and like a lot of like violent lyrics on this one.
Yeah,
more violent lyrics on this one than maybe their debut.
Definitely their darkest album.
Yeah,
I would say like in terms of content and subject matter and stuff like that.
Yeah, this is a really evil one.
Yeah.
One of their most well-known, and that album cover is just perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you could talk about it all day, but this is just a classic masterpiece.
Mm-hmm.
And then, lastly, we have an interview disc.
Yes. This is not, like, a full-length album or anything, but pretty cool picture disc.
Yeah. Just
an interview?
Yeah. And I think, I don't think we've shown like the other side of this picture disc on our channel yet.
Okay.
The first side is just a live picture of Dave.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have the cool band shot.
Very 80s.
Yeah. I haven't listened to this yet, but both of these pictures are from the So Far So Good So What era.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I'll have to listen to it soon. That is such a cool picture of Dave.
Okay.
But yeah, that's all that we have.
Mm-hmm.
The only Megadeth albums that we are missing are 13, and Cryptic Writings and Risk. Yes. Which Cryptic Writings goes for $400, mm-hmm. and Risk has never been pressed. And I just haven't gotten around to getting 13 yet.
Yeah. And Cryptic Writings is my personal favorite Megadeth record. Uh-huh. So the day that we come across one that's actually affordable, or the day that it gets reissued, I will be a very happy, very happy person. Because mm-hmm. I think that is their number one, personally. I just have a personal connection to all those songs. I think they're more my style. You know, as much as I appreciate Rust in Peace, you know, the very technical, the very complex, I can get into that, but like, just those songs and Cryptic Writings, they like, they were made for me.
Yeah. A Secret Place is my favorite.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, this is all of our Megadeth records.
Yes.
I think we have, I mean, we have all of them except for those three, and I'm not sure if there's a video on YouTube that has, that shows like, The World Needs a Hero and like, United Abominations.
Right.
I feel like this might be the most comprehensive Megadeth vinyl collection video.
Maybe.
Not the toot our own horn, but I haven't seen a video that showed The World Needs a Hero and stuff.
If anybody were to know about whether that video exists or not, it'd be it.
Yeah, and if you guys know, let me know, because I'd love to see it.
Yeah.
I want to see like a video of somebody who has Cryptic Writings.
There's got to be somebody on there.
Yeah.
But we do have other comprehensive collections. Probably our most massive one on our channel right now is the Type of Negative one that you did by yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So definitely go check out our other videos. We do ranked, we do vinyl updates, just a bunch of different kind of vinyl related videos on our channel.
Yeah, so let us know what we could do,
mm-hmm.
if we should rank these. We were planning on doing that, but we didn't have time to get a list down.
Yeah.
So yeah. Just let us know what you want to see. We obviously have a big collection back here.
Yes, and I have way more where I live.
Yep.
So yeah, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.